So let us talk about managing tables while performing import, Hive import. So already we have seen simple Hive import, and we have used Hive import, Hive database, and Hive table to specify the target table for loading the data. And now let us talk about managing the tables while performing Hive import. And if you understand, typically we have to do three things while loading the data. One, especially to any target location. One, we might have to append to the existing data or merge. Merge is not very straightforward, so let's defer for merge. Let's talk about append. Second, you just want to overwrite every time you load into the same location. And third, if there is a target location already created, means if there is data in the target location or in the target table where we are trying to import into, then we just have to write the exception and error out. So these three are the typical requirements which we will see. And there are several control arguments which we need to understand in that process. The default behavior which we have seen earlier as part of the simple Hive import is, if the table doesn't exist, it will create the table and then it will add the data into the table, which we have already seen. And if you run again the same command, it will just append to the existing location. So let's do that. Let us run the same command which we have run earlier, which is this one. Before running it, let's make sure that there is data in this location already. So I'm connecting to Hive here. And the target database is this one. So let me paste it. And then let us run show tables. There is this table, order ITM, yes. So first let me drop this table because there is a mistake in the table name. So let me drop this and then exit. And let me run this Hive import with the fixed table name. Okay. And let me copy this and paste it. So it's almost done. The import is done, and now it have loaded to the Hive table also. And you can see there are two files in this location. We can also validate by going to Hive, switching to the database, and then running a query on top of it. Okay, show tables, and this is the table name. We can run a command called describe formatted order underscore items, and you can see the location here. We can copy this location. So this is where the table will be pointing to. The so in Hive, the table is nothing but a HDFS location, and this is the path. Okay, and also we can actually run select count command from order items. You can see there are 172,198 records, and I'm exiting from here. We will also review the files in the location the table is pointing to, the HDFS location and the table is pointing to. And you can see there are two files here, and we also ran a query to get the count. We have 172,198 records. Let us run the same query once again, same scoop command once again, and let us see what will happen. This will be the default behavior. We just specified Hive import, Hive database, and Hive table. We haven't specified anything else. So let us run this once again. Now you can see there are four files, and also size is a bit bigger. It's almost 10 MB earlier. You can see there were two files with 5.4 MB. As we ran the same scoop import without any filtering or anything, it just appended the same data once again. Because there will be no constraints and all in the file system, it just copied everything without any issues. And now we can log into Hive once again. We can switch the database and we can run the query. And it will show 3,000, 44,000, whatever number it is. And also we can actually run this Hadoop fs-ls on the location to see four files, not two files, but four files. Okay, so this is the default behavior of the scoop import. Now let's consider the second one, where we want to create the complete snapshot every time. We don't want to append to the existing location. For that, what you have to do is, let's copy this. And then specify Hive overwrite. So instead of appending, which is by default, we are trying to overwrite on the existing location. So if you run this query, if you run this scoop command, it will actually overwrite the existing directory. It will drop the directory, it will probably drop the table, recreate the table, and load the data into the table. We are almost at the end, and you will see there will be only two files and 5.4 MB. Okay, we can also validate by running Hadoop fsls command. We will see only two files. If it is default behavior, we should have seen six files, because earlier we already have four files. Now the third approach of managing the tables is, if the table already exists, it should just fail. It shouldn't overwrite, or it should append to the table. For that, there is a highly confusing control argument, which is called as create Hive table. If it is set, then the job will fail if the target Hive table exists. By default, this property is false. So there are multiple issues with this. I don't know who developed this, who documented this. Instead of exists, exists, it is exists here. So that is one documentation error. And then even the name, we typically think that if we specify this argument, if the table doesn't exist, it will create the table. It says create Hive table, but it is not the case. It's highly confusing. If you do not set, it is false. That means it will just append to the data, or if you use Hive overwrite, it will drop the directory of the table and then it will load the data. This additional this argument, which is typically mutually exclusive argument for Hive overwrite, will actually fail if the table already exists. I don't know why they named it like that. So let's see the command. Let's see the example here. And we typically either use Hive overwrite or create Hive table. We should not use both, even if the command runs. You should not use both in your code. It will become unmanageable. Hive overwrite and create Hive table, fundamentally mutually exclusive. If the table already exists, if you want to overwrite, then you use Hive overwrite. If you want to fail, then you use create Hive table. You cannot try overwriting and failing at the same time. So even if it works, with one or the other behavior, make sure you use only one argument, either Hive overwrite or create Hive table, don't use both. That being said, let me run this command once again to see the behavior. If we do not have create hive table or hive overwrite, we should have four files. If we have hive overwrite, we should have only two files. Now also we'll have only two files. So only thing is it will fail as the target table already exists. And other set of issues here is, instead of failing before doing the import, it will fail after the import. I don't know why they have designed like this. It will actually fail after the import is done, almost just before copying the data from a staging location into the location pointed by the hive table, it will fail. Until then, if you see, the import is already taken care of, which means if you have a 10 GB data, and if it take half an hour, it will do all the work and then it will say, it will fail, okay, table already exists, I cannot complete the scoop import, like this. And another side effect is, typically when you actually perform scoop import into hive table, before copying into the hive table as part of the last step, it will actually copy the data into a staging location, and that staging location will be your home directory. In my case, my home directory in HDFS is user D Gadiraju. Okay, in this, whatever table we are trying to copy from source, the table name is order items in this case, there will be a directory created and the data will be copied to this location first before copying the files to the actual target location. If the scoop import is successful, this directory will be deleted after the copying is done. But if the scoop import fails for whatever reason, this will remain like this. Okay, which is another bug in this process. I don't know that create hive table, who designed it, who implemented it. It's a bit buggy, confusing, and all those things. So make sure you practice a bit and you understand the purpose of this create hive table a bit in detail, and also the side effects such as this, where the cleanup is not done properly. Okay, so that being said, now if I want to run it again, let's say this is the issue which you want to handle in a different manner. If the table exists, you just want to run hive overwrite again. If I try to run this, typically if everything is clean, this should execute without any issues, but now it will fail saying a different error, and it will fail even before doing the import. You can see here, user D Gadiraju order items already exists. Typically, who are naive to scoop, they will confuse why it is failing on this location. The reason is, if you go back to the logs, first it will do the import. Let me show you which is successful. First it will do the import. Here the location is not mentioned anywhere, but by this time that location, which is /user/username / the table which we are trying to copy from the source database, under that location this data is copied by this time. After that, it will actually move data from that location to actual location where hive table is pointing to. Okay, and then it will clean up by deleting the directory files and everything on that stage location. So it is actually complaining on the stage location, even though it is a bit misleading error. That is the reason why it is actually throwing on the stage location, throwing exception on the stage location. To fix this, we have to run this additional command, Hadoop-rm-R user D Gadiraju order items. And then you can actually perform the scoop import in overwrite mode. Again, if you run create hive table mode, as the target table already exists in hive, it will just fail. In this case, I just want to overwrite if the table already exists. So I'm running the command again with hive overwrite, not with create a Hive table option. Okay, so these three are the scenarios which we need to consider. One is to append, second is to overwrite, and third one is raise the exception. The default behavior when we say Hive import is to append if the table already exists. Hive overwrite is to overwrite the table, and create Hive table is to fail if the target table already exists. On top of these things, let us finish this import successfully. Then I will explain a few other things which you need to consider. We are almost there. Now the import is done. Now, if you go back to the documentation, there are additional Hive control arguments. They are not that important, but if you want, you can practice before going to certification. I will not be covering those things. You can ignore partitioning for the certification for now, as we are primarily focused on certifications at this time. You might not have to consider these things. Even in the projects also, we don't use this partitioning and directly load into the partition tables using scoop with Hive import. Hence, you can ignore for now. If you want, you can explore. And then finally, there is another argument called map column Hive. So typically, the data types on the source tables and the data types on the target tables in Hive will be different, and the intelligence which runs the scoop import will take care of mapping the source column types to Hive specific column types. But at times you might want to customize those things. That time we give map column Hive. You can give the column name in the table which we are trying to import, and then equal to, and then you can give the target data type, which is Hive valid data type. So instead of using defaults, it will use this custom data types for the columns while creating the tables in Hive. That is the purpose of map column Hive. Okay, so that concludes importing data into Hive. So you just have to practice this. It's a bit important for both certifications as well as the project purposes.